my friends, it's me Nikki here, and I hope you all are doing great. I'm here with a holiday DIY, and it's how I put together a leftover station. This is a little station that I have that I'm going to sit out this Thanksgiving and Christmas for guests to fix them a beautiful to-go plate when they're getting ready to go. They can come to this one area and they'll have everything they need to pack up all the food they want to pack up. And so I've been doing my Thanksgiving prep, and I've been doing my Christmas prep and kitchen renovations and 10 million other projects, and so I'm happy to have this one done. I wanted something that I can pack away in my entertainment closet, so this works perfectly, so I want to jump in and share with you how I put it together. So we're in that closet where I keep all of those things where I do entertaining, home entertaining and things like that, all of my platters and dishes and things like that. And so I recently made this closet over. It had a much needed makeover that it needed, and I have a video on that, so I'll link that below. But what I wanted was a station that I could mobily pull out whenever I have guests during Christmas, picnics during the summer, or Thanksgiving, and it would be a station where people could pack them a beautiful to-go plate, have everything they need, and it's already set up so I could just pull it out and I won't have to kind of put it together each time I'm hosting something. I wanted something that could fit in this closet, which I found the perfect piece here, this wired shelf that it kind of expands out. I can also hang it on my door, but I just need the attachment to do so in this closet, but it sits here fine also. And so it was very affordable at Tuesday morning. I think it was like right at $50, so I was so happy about that. So I want to show you kind of how I tweaked it, and I'm sorry that this closet is kind of dark. It's hard to record in here, so I'm trying to do the best I can, but I will take you out of this closet to kind of show you each aspect of this here and how I put it together and where I got things and that kind of thing. But it's really something neat to have. I have it all prepped and ready to be ready for Thanksgiving. I'm so excited about that, and then I can easily switch it over for Christmas. So let's get started. Okay, so I pulled it out. The lighting is not much better, and then ignore the chaos behind you because everything in my house is everywhere, in the kitchen, in the living room. We're just making spaces to get appliances in and just finding a place to sit everything, so it's a bit of craziness. But I wanted to give you a scan down view first of everything, and then I want to take you in and kind of show you the little touches that I did. Now, at the bottom here is where I put sparkling grape juice. I got it for $2.99 at Target and customized it. Now, I'll show you a little bit more about that later. I have some boxes for them to pack beautiful kind of dessert box where they can put all kinds of desserts in one box, along with kind of takeout boxes and soup containers so that they can put gravy in there, little containers to put their cranberry sauce and napkins and spoons and coffee cups and cups and straws. So I have everything covered. The only thing I need to add to this is aluminum foil and Ziploc bags so that they can put, like, if they want to put rolls in a Ziploc bag and then the foil to cover their food and things like that. So let me show you the special touches. Okay, the first thing I wanted to do is label my leftover station because I wanted something that would be versatile. So I love these wood labels that I get from Michaels. I'm here picking them out today. And they come in different shapes and they're only 99 cents each, but they'll last forever. But I wanted something that I could change up because at Christmas I want to label it differently. During the summer I may want to label it differently. During the year I can use this to store all of my paper goods. So it's going to have dual function. So I'm not just only using this during the holidays. I can keep all of my paper goods on here throughout the year. So it works out great. But I found this 20-piece chalkboard label set that fits perfectly on the wood block here, so I just stuck it on there, and it was only $2, and it was good to go. So the next thing were labels. I had these labels printed, and this is something that you totally can do as a DIY. The reason I had mine printed was because I just didn't have a lot of time lately, and it was easier for me to do this, but you can go to Office Depot and any office supply store, buy these labels yourself, and print them yourself. I wanted labels to do customized sparkling grape juice bottles for each household to take with them, to take back to their room or wherever they're going. And then I also wanted labels so that they could label their food and put what was in each container, or they can put on their main bag once they pack everything up and put their name on it. In case they're not leaving right away, they know which kind of bag is their bag. So these were printed up from a company, and I'll link that company below if you're interested. But again, you don't have to do that. You can so easily do this yourself. And so it's so fun to put this together because I think it's just a special gift to give to your guest as they leave, and kind of something to remember the day by, along with very affordable to do. And you can do wine or whatever you choose to do, but I did sparkling juice. And so up top here is where I have for coffee and drinks and straws. And I got this from the Dollar Spot. The straws are in the from Target, and the jar is from the Dollar Spot. And I put a chalkboard label on it. The little scallop little containers here came from Target. The wood utensils I ordered offline, and everything is going to be in the link below. You click on it and you'll see everything for this video that I possibly could share. And then the plaid here is from Target also. This is hot right now. They're into the plaid and all of that. So I thought the white would look good with the plaid along with the wood and be nice for kind of a Thanksgiving feel. But the thing is, the plaid can be a little more expensive. I think it was maybe $3 a pack, and I didn't want to invest a lot of money into the paper products. So I just got one pack of each to give me the color and the fun. And then you'll notice the rest of my napkins and the rest of my plates are the basic white, affordable. So when you mix them together, it gives you a great look, but you did it on a budget. So you didn't kind of break the bank by getting all of the plaid. And I actually like the mixture of having the plaid and the white. I think it breaks it up nicely instead of just having completely all of the plaid. So that worked out great there. But definitely check out your Target for that. That plaid line is just really cute and really on trend right now. So I thought it was perfect. So the next shelf here is where I have kind of the to-go boxes here. I have kind of the takeout boxes where they can put dressing in there. They could put potatoes, whatever they want. And I got these from Michael's. They come in white and you can get them in the craft color too. I have the little condiment things here that I got from Target to put cranberry sauce or any condiments in there with the lid, along with the soup kind of containers here so that they can put gravy in there or whatever they want to put in there. Now the next shelf here is where I have all of my bags here. Again, got only a couple of the plaid to blend in, and then the bulk of it are the craft bags, which are larger to, so that they can fit all of their to-go things in there. So once they pack everything up, they get a bag, they can throw everything in there, and they're good to go. And so the great thing about this is that it still has the look, but you didn't have to invest a lot of money, because mostly people are going to have enough to pack the larger craft bags, so that worked out perfect. But again, I want to mention here, with this setup here, you don't have to do kind of the if you want to do something like this, you can do something on your counter. Set up a counter space with a leftover kind of packing station. So there's so many different variations that you can do this. If you have a tray, maybe in your room, or a table, you can set up a table, a sofa table, you can set it up. So you can use the dollar store. They have plates and bags and all kinds of things. So many creative ways and so many different resources to kind of have you a leftover station. Now, also in this bin here, I have these four burlap bags. They came in a set of four from Target. I had already had these copper kind of tags here that I got from the Target Dollar Spot a while back. And so in here, I have the different condiments, which is pepper, salt, creamer, sugar. I still need to purchase it and put it in there. That's going to be on my grocery list, but I went ahead and got everything prepared. So that when they pack up, they just get in the bag and get how many ever they need of what, throw it in their bag, and they're good to go. So it's an easy way to store it. Along with from Michael's, I bought these big dessert boxes so that each household can fix their own dessert box, and they can put a variety of cakes and pies and cookies and all kinds of things in there. And they actually don't have to put the cookies in there, because if you see the little white bags beside that, those are little cookie bags so that they can pack cookies up also. I have the little label on here that says I am thankful for leftovers, so that they can put their name on there or whatever they choose to. So that's just kind of a fun little twist on it there. And the last touch here is I put the pen here so that they have a place that they can write, you know, grab the pen and write whatever they need to write down on their thing. So this is kind of everything. And like I said, it's great because during the year, it's stored in my closet there, and it's the storage for all of my paper products. And so this is really an organization system for paper products also. So it's really dual function, and I love that about it. I love how it fits in my cabinet, and it still keeps things neat and orderly, and it has a space. So, you know, find that perfect piece that fits you, you know, that fits your space. And you can do this, like I said, on the counter. You don't have to necessarily have a piece like this. You can kind of do a caddy style if you want something a little smaller, however you want to do it. If you do some type of leftover station this holiday season, please join me on Instagram, tag me, or on Facebook and tag me so that I can see. I love seeing all the wonderful things you guys do. You inspire me also. And so I hope you all have enjoyed my sharing my little journey here. I'm so happy to have this done. This is one thing off of my Thanksgiving to-do list that I have done, so I can get that marked off. So that's fun, and I hope you all are having a fun time and wonderful time with your holiday prep. So this is Nikki saying goodbye.